and that Aesthetic Impact offers this as a think tank or sharing of information environment, because much information about our personal abilities and selves is not known. I think it would behoove us to get together, everybody from every science who is interested in this, to develop our personal knowledge of our personal selves, because we're learning that, and I will hold this book up, hopefully you can see it. There are people who have been studying us and our abilities for a very long time. Here is a book, I know, and so much for that, but it's Seeing the Invisible. In England, at the Religious Institute at Oxford, there are 5,000 stories in this book of people who were just doing their normal everyday activities, and their entire world changed around them. Whether or not they decided to blow that off as a bad night of bad pizza, or continue on, or it became a defining moment, it doesn't matter. It just showed them that there is something about themselves that they totally did not understand. And where we're here today to make any groundbreaking, world-shaking, life-saving efforts, I highly doubt. But we'll each take away from Paul's presentation a bit of new knowledge, and he is a very gifted presenter. And Aesthetic Impact is not a substitute for medical advice or your medical practitioner. So if you have a health condition, I am advised to tell you, please seek medical treatment. Now, I am going to give you Paul. He is director of and project manager of PSI, Pure Stream Information, Control Remote Viewer, Energy Psychology Trainer, International Speaker, Architect, and Writer. Paul is a Control Remote Viewer, having trained to advanced level with Lynn Buchanan of Problem Solutions Innovation, and is the coordinator for PSI trainings in Ireland. In 2008, Paul and Andrew Usher participated in a project for artist Karen Russo to explore aspects of remote viewing that she thought relevant to her work as an artist. In 2009, Paul, Hennick, and Roth, and Sarah Berg performed PSI, Pure Stream Information, a European-based professional remote viewing consultancy service. As an architect by profession, Paul is also director of, I'm going to have to let you clarify, because that is an Irish term and I've heard you say it, a design consultancy specializing in accelerated problem solving and concept development, particularly related to sustainability, innovation, and design. He's also an artist and writer, has a background in military history and war game simulations, and is currently writing a hopefully fictional novel about the strategic impacts of a group d'état in contemporary Ireland. Now, with all that being said, I am going to turn this over and change the role to Paul O'Connor and let him begin to present his information to you today. Paul?
Hi, Teresa.
Hi.
I'm just setting up video here, and I'm going to pull up the presentation. So hello
to
everybody.
Put you in the driver's seat.
Thanks. Okay, this is just loading up. Hi to everybody. I see some familiar names. Hi, Lynn. Hi, Silver. Marco. Gary. And other friends that I met at the IRVA conference last year. You're very welcome. And thank you for joining us for this evening. Okay. And thank you, Teresa, for organizing this. There's a lot of work that goes into doing this, and it's greatly appreciated.
You're welcome.
As Teresa was saying, I am a control remote viewer trained by Lynn Buchanan. I am the organizer, in effect, of PSI, Pure Stream Information. And the word that Teresa couldn't figure out is actually a Greek word. The word is Daedalus. Daedalus was a creative consultancy that I have. Daedalus was the father of Icarus. He was the architect who created the labyrinth for the Minotaur. So that's just one of those side stories. What I want to talk about this evening is something that I've been working with for about the last 10 years called energy psychology techniques. And they're an amazing family or suite of tools that seem to just plug straight in to accessing the body systems and accessing the subconscious. And what I began to find when I started learning remote viewing is that I found these tools very useful because I started to integrate them into the work that I was doing. Not as part of the CRV process, but as an aid to the performance of CRV or any form of remote viewing or psychic functioning. So let's see how this goes. If you do have questions, there is a Q&A box on the right, but halfway down the right-hand side of your screen. There's a box there where you can type in. I think, Teresa, you may need to enable the Q&A box. And if you have other questions, either hold them to the end or get them into the Q&A box, and we'll address them as best I can. Okay. So where are we going today? There are a number of things I want to explore. The first thing is, what are we? What is the nature of our physical human being? How do we access non-local information? What disrupts that process? What new tools do we have to deal with that disruption? And then show you how they can improve our specific performance as remote viewers. And along the way, we'll be doing some exercises to give you practical applications. You know, me talking about energy psychology techniques is about as interesting as me talking about remote viewing. If you've never done it before, it doesn't make any sense until you actually try it. So I want to give you an experience of doing that. And we will do that at a number of points through the presentation. But I want to start with a story. If I'm speaking too fast for anybody, I apologize. I come from a country where it rains a lot, and we tend to want to say what we have to say so we get back into the pub as quickly as possible. So I will try to pace it so that I'm not speaking too quickly. So the story. The story starts with Dr. Roger Callahan. Roger was in the war, came back. He left the army and was allowed to go to college. And so he decided to study psychology because he figured if he could study psychology, he could figure out some of the things that were problems for him and maybe get rid of them. And he became one of the first psychologists in his state, and he also became quite a leader in the field. And he would have clients coming in for quite long periods of time, you know, 12 months, 18 months on programs, trying to deal with issues that were up for them. And he had one particular client, a woman called Mary. And Mary had an extreme water phobia. She was aquaphobic. It was very, very severe. Now, the thing about this severity of it is that she could not drive along the Pacific Highway. Just looking at water terrified her. She said Jaws was the best movie that ever came out because her kids stopped asking to go to the beach. But she couldn't even stand in a shower without becoming extremely anxious. She could only stand in about a half inch, which is about 2 to 3 centimeters of water, and would be quite agitated. Roger managed to get her to the point where he could sit her on the edge of his pool after 18 months, but she would still be very, very, very nervous. So Roger was always looking to find some way of improving his performance as a psychologist, because he discovered from his colleagues that success levels were actually quite low. You know, he noticed his success level was about 18 to 20%. And his professional peers were going, "Wow, that's great, you know, because we're only getting about 12% success rate." So he would always look into alternative methods or techniques, and he came across kinesiology. And one day, Mary came in and said, "Dr. Callahan, you know, I don't think I'll be able to work today. I've got this really bad stomach ache. It's really bad pain in my stomach." And he said, "Well, you know, I've just been doing this course on kinesiology, and it talks about these energy channels running through the body. And they say that there's one that runs under your eye here, which is to do with your stomach. And maybe if you tapped or rubbed that point under your eye, it might help to relieve the stomach ache." So she began tapping under her eye, as I'm showing in the video, and suddenly she declared, "It's gone." And he went, "What's gone?" And at this stage, she was up, she was bolted from the chair, was heading out to the pool, and she was shouting, "It's gone, the water thing is gone." And see, he suddenly thought, "Whoa, hang on a second, she can't swim." And he dashed out after her. And by the time he got there, she was down by the edge of the pool, saying, "No, no, it's okay, it's okay." And she was splashing water on her face, laughing, saying, "It's gone, it's gone, it's completely gone." And Callahan had no idea what happened. And just to show that it wasn't a flash in the pan, you know, it wasn't some kind of one-off thing, and that the problem came back later, he actually got a postcard from her a year later, because she was on a cruise liner in the middle of the Pacific with her sisters on a holiday, on a cruise holiday. So the water phobia had completely gone. And so Callahan started asking the question, like, what happened? Now, before we go into that, I think this is a good point to give you an experience of using a variation on this technique. Callahan took this to another level. He developed a technique called thought field therapy, or TFT, out of this. But one of his students, a guy called Gary Craig, simplified it enormously and brought out a technique called emotional freedom technique, which he tested by going around the VA hospitals. They're the veteran army hospitals, for those who aren't from the States, where people who've been in the war who need aid or assistance are treated. And there are guys in there who, you know, haven't had a decent night's sleep in years because of their combat experiences, combat trauma. And Gary went around the hospitals testing out the technique that he developed. And they found that guys who had years of war trauma and traumatic memories were suddenly clearing these memories and getting their lives back. So Gary thought this is too important to hold, and he actually made it openly available on the web through his website, emofree.com. But like I said, there's no point talking about it. The best thing is to do it. So here's my invitation to you. Choose a fear or a phobia, something that you would like to change.